Hi, yes, we are teachers, lifelong learners. But this video is for the future teachers. Yes, this video for the BEd teacher candidates. And today we are going to discuss on the pre-university examination question answer discussion 2021 for the course quality and management of school education. And you can see here, results are here. Today only I displayed the results. And you can see that many means more than I think 50-60% students, they got more than 70% marks. So it indicates that practice makes better. If you are new on the channel, then please like this video, share this video with your friends, subscribe this channel, and don't forget to press on bell button. Yes, so let's have drilling on the MCQ question answer discussions. Yes. First of all, I congratulate you because I think instead of words, the picture, this speaks more. Okay, so I'm going to share something with you.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, the screen is visible to everyone.
Oh, wow.
See, so here what you can see, these are the average score, this is the median score, and this is the highest score. And just look at the graph which is given below, you can see the scoring. And you can see that the many students, they got more than 60% marks in the pre-university examination course 201 quality and management of school education. It is really nice, it is really appreciable, is it so? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes. And this happens only because of the drilling. So drilling is very important for gaining anything, for getting achievement. Okay. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am. But I would like to add one more point. It depends upon you also, because you contribute yourself from your side a lot.
Yes, that is true. But I think see, now also only many very few students are there in the meeting. Okay, this is also matter, but if the teachers
but
are taking efforts,
we watch your videos, whatever you record,
yes,
maybe watch,
yes,
that.
Yes, I know that, and because of that only I have recorded the videos and uploaded the videos on the YouTubes. Okay, so today we are going to discuss on the pre-university examination question paper, that was the MCQ examination, and I'm not going to explain each question in detail because already we have explained some questions in the previous class, right? So should I share the PDF? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Pre-university examination 2020-2021 BEd course 201 quality and management of school education, and this exam was held on the date 11 May 2021, and total 40 questions were there. All questions were compulsory. Okay, now it's your turn to give correct responses. Yes. Yes. The question number one is, in which type of leadership decision making is completely in the hands of the follower? And the options are autocratic, democratic, delegative, and participative. Now tell me which is the correct one. Yes, I'm expecting quick responses because already you are given this examination and you got good marks in the examination also.
Delegative.
Yes, the correct option is delegative. See, I'm not going to explain because already we have did explanation on these questions. So do you really want explanation for this or no? Yes or no, just let me know.
No.
Okay, good. Why teacher training is necessary? This is the second question, and the options are increase teaching skills, understand methods of school organization, upgrade knowledge of the content, and the last is all of the above. Now tell me which is the correct option.
All of the above.
Yes. Now again you are having confusion that some are saying that the second option, that is understand methods.
No, I'm not saying second, I'm saying the last one, all of the
yes
above.
So should I log this option?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. The third question is premature withdrawal of children from schools at any stage before completion of the primary courses is called as, the options are injustice, stagnation, wastage and demotivation. Which is the correct one?
Stagnation.
Okay. Yes. See, so you have already eliminated the option number 1 and 4, that is injustice and demotivation. And now you are having confusion between the two, that is stagnation and wastage. See, the stagnation, it is quite closer to the stagnant. Stagnation means ek jagah pe ruk jana. Okay. And the wastage means what? Yes. So if the meaning of stagnation is ek jagah pe ruk jana. Yes. So now tell me which is the correct one. For example, yes, again you are sticking with the second. See, stagnation and wastage, there is a difference. Whenever, suppose the particular course is for, we'll take example of our course only, the B.Ed. course, it is for the 2 years. And suppose instead of 2 years, the someone is take the more than 2 years. Okay, means in the second year, in the first year, if someone got fail, and again he is in the same class. So that is nothing but the stagnation. And wastage means what? So because of some other reason, suppose a particular student is going to withdraw from the school. That is nothing but the wastage. Clear? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm unable to see the.
Maybe you have internet connection problem. So just wait for some time.
Okay, ma'am.
Because this MS team is, it requires the more bandwidth. That is the reason.
Okay.
So correct option is the wastage. And wastage is nothing but premature withdrawal of a children from a school at any stage before completion of the primary courses. पहली बार जब भी आप क्वेश्चन रीड करते हो आपको थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन हो जाता है, लेकिन अगर आपकी कॉन्सेप्ट्स क्लियर है देन इजीली यू कैन फाइंड आउट द ऑप्शन. स्टैग्नेशन यानी एक जगह पे रुक जाना. अगर कोई भी बच्चा फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड में है और वो पास नहीं होता, वो उसी स्टैंडर्ड में रह जाता है, वो फेल होने की वजह से, दैट इज नथिंग बट द स्टैग्नेशन. वो वहीं पे रुक जा रहा है, वो आगे नहीं जा रहा है, उसकी ग्रोथ नहीं हो रही है. दैट इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ स्टैग्नेशन. And wastage means what? Suppose because of some other matters, maybe family reasons, maybe some other reasons, particular, जैसे कि ragging हो रहा है, किसी ने 11th standard में ही school छोड़ दिया, college छोड़ दिया, तो वो क्या है? That is nothing but the wastage. मतलब particular course complete होने के पहले ही वो course को छोड़ना, that is nothing but the wastage. The concepts are clear? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, you might be having confusion because this is the new question for you. Which relative position of seat and desk may be useful for both reading and writing? Now, tell me your answers. The options are plus, minus, zero, and none of the above. No idea? Okay, no problem. Now, I'm going to... Yes. Presentation is visible to everyone. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Yes. See, these are the different positions of the bench and desk. You can see here plus, zero, and minus. See, plus. See the position of the plus, zero. There is no gap between the desk and bench. And here you can see the minus position also. So the question was, which relative position of seat and desk may be useful for both reading and writing? I think I have asked two questions based on this sitting position. And here you can see that the zero position is maybe useful for reading and writing. जब भी आप देखो, आप भी घर में बैठे हो, आप घर में या अभी जब भी आप कॉलेज में बैठते हो, सी द पोजीशन, आप लिखने के टाइम पे आप क्या करते हो आप? यस, आपका जो भी ये है बेंच है, आप कहाँ पे लेते हो? थोड़ा सा आगे खिसकाते हो उसको, आगे सरकाते हो उसको आप. यस, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द सी. So for reading the seat should be in the plus position and for writing it should be in the minus position. So ये writing का position है, that is minus position. वहाँ पे हम क्या करते हैं, जो भी हमारा bench है उसको थोड़ा सा आगे हम सरकाते हैं ताकि हम अच्छे से लिख पाए. So that is nothing but the minus position and in the plus position there is a gap between the bench and desk. And what about the zero position? The sometimes it is not possible because there are the, if you see the benches and desks, they are the fixed, wo attached rehte hai. So that position is nothing but the zero position when there is a no gap between the bench and desk. And this position is useful for both reading and writing. Is it clear to you? Maybe you are not having these notes and you will get it later. Definitely I will share to you. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so I'm going to clock the option that is zero. According to Raibhan, space between seat and table should be proper. For reading the seat, should be in the plus position. For writing, the seat should be in the minus position and all of the above.
Ma'am, it should be all of the above.
Yes, because already you saw the answer in the previous, whatever slides I displayed before you, the answer was there and the correct answer is all of the above. Yes, the next question is academic duty of supervisor is, and the options are guide teachers, improve working environment, coordinate educational activity, and the fourth one is all of the above. Yes, I'm expecting quick responses because already you have given this examination.
Ma'am, all of the above.
Yes, very nice answer. Good. Which is not a professional quality of the principal? And the options are well-trained, qualified and experienced, impressive personality. The third is ability to motivate and inspire. And the fourth one is good at handling human resources.
And second one, I think impressive personality.
Yes, because here the, you see, first we have to read the question here given the not, which is not a professional quality. And if we see there are basically, we're going to divide the qualities, that is personal quality and professional quality. And if we see whatever options are given here, so this quality, that is impressive personality, it comes under the personal quality, not under the professional quality. So here we are going to log the option number two, that is impressive personality. Yes. The next question is, leadership is defined as lifting a man's vision, raising the performance to a higher standard, and building a man's personality. This definition is given by, and the options are Peter Drucker, L.D. Haskey, Raibhan, and none of the above. Now tell me which is the correct option. Yes, see, for this question you have to first you can use the elimination factor. So of course Raibhan, it is related to the infrastructure facilities, the arrangement between the bench and desk, and now we have to select the options, any one option from these three options. Okay, so here first the thing, whenever there is a question related to definitions, you have to know the name of the author and you have to know the definitions also. So ye aapka trick hai, aap particular jo bhi keywords hai usko dhyan mein rakhna hai aur aapko ye tabhi aap usko identify kar paoge kaun se author ne kaun sa definition diya hua hai. Okay, so now I'm going to again share the screen. Here you can see that, you can see the different definitions of leadership given by the different author. Okay, now tell me which is the correct option. See, L.D. Haskey, he also given the definition of leadership. Okay, and one more, that is Peter Drucker, he also given the definition of leadership. Now tell me which is the correct option. See, you can see that the Peter Drucker is here and L.D. Haskey is here. Now again, I'm going to share the screen. Slide sharing. Yes. Here you can see that these are the different definitions of the leadership, and the whatever definition is there in the question paper, and that is, that definition is given by the Peter Drucker. The definition is, it is defined as lifting a man's vision, raising the performance to a higher standard, and building a man's personality. Okay, so again, and there are some other definitions given by the L.D. Haskey, given by the Dwight and the Chester Bernard. Okay, so you should by heart all these definitions and just remember the keywords. Okay, for Peter Drucker, you can remember the lifting or the man's vision. Here, the leadership, that is the relation between the persons. In this definition, you can decide it that the ability. So these are the keywords. You have to remember these keywords. So accordingly, you can select the name of the particular author. Yes, is it clear to you? Yes, should I move ahead? Yes, today.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, which is the correct option here? Option number one, that is Peter Drucker. Yes. The next question is --- is a remedy to overcome problem of indiscipline. The options are positive reinforcement, monitorial method, proper arrangement of timetable, and last is all of the above.
All of the above.
Yes, very nice. Yes. Again, this question is new for you. First, tell me, just read this question and tell me this question is related to which topic? Because it indicates that your study, the progress of your study. The question is --- recommended the setting up of multipurpose school, which have infrastructure like workshops for technical education and laboratories for imparting practical training. And the options are the Kothari Commission, the second is the Mudaliar Commission, the third is the UNESCO, and fourth is none of the above. Now tell me which is the correct option. First, tell me this particular question is related to which topic. इसी से समझ में आएगा कि आपने आपकी पढ़ाई कैसे चल रही है, आप सच में पढ़ाई कर रहे हो कि नहीं, और अगर आप कर रहे हो तो शायद आपने ये टॉपिक के ऊपर पढ़ाई नहीं की है. Yes, no idea. See, if you don't know, please say no. We don't know. We don't have any idea. Yes.
Ma'am, I have locked the Kothari Commission.
Okay, means you are saying that this is the recommendation given by the Kothari Commission. Okay, let's see the correct answer. Again, I'm going to share the screen. Yes. So basically, this question is related to the vocationalization. Just recall the unit number 3, and one topic was there, that is vocationalization. So if we see here, you can see about the UNESCO, about the Kothari Commission, and about the Mudaliar Commission. And just read this very fast and tell me what is the correct answer. So according to you, your answer is the Kothari Commission. Now tell me the correct one. The Kothari Commission, is it the correct one, or the any other answer is correct? Yes. Now I'm again switching on the previous one. Yes. Now tell me which is the correct answer.
UNESCO, ma'am. UNESCO.
See, here we are talking about the recommendation. Please read the question carefully. What UNESCO is saying? UNESCO in 1974, he defined the vocationalization term. See, yes, of course. See, here what you have written, the few others define, and the specifically they have written about the Kothari Commission and about the Mudaliar Commission also. So here, if we see the question, the Mudaliar Commission, it gives the recommendation the setting up of multipurpose school, which have infrastructure like workshop for technical education and laboratories for imparting practical training. So now tell me which is the correct one, because the Kothari Commission was of the view of general education should be remain in close in contact with the productivity. See, maybe they will ask question based on this also. Yes. So who gave the recommendation that the general education should be remains close to contact with the productivity? Okay, so such type of question they may ask in your final examination. Again, you have to remember the UNESCO, and when the UNESCO defined the term vocationalization, maybe there may be chances to ask questions based on this also. Yes. Now tell me the correct option. Yes.
And B, modular Mudaliar.
Yes, the correct option is the second option, that is the B, Mudaliar Commission. Very nice. Yes, now this is a very simple question. I'm expecting quick response from your side. Timetable is defined as the dash dash that reflect the entire educational program followed in the school.
Mirror.
Yes, mirror. The word here, we should recall the word that reflect. Is reflect, and the answer is mirror. Very nice. Dash dash value is reflected in the timetable. I'm expecting answer with the justification. Yes.
What?
Yes. Can you justify this?
Moral values like following timetable means
regularity and all these things.
Yes, and psychological means. See, if we see the timetable, it shows that systematicness, it shows the punctuality. So we can correlate it with the moral values. And tell me about the psychological values.
You're preparing for the next one.
See, psychological values means what? Always, like, yes.
So they will follow accordingly. Okay, we have to read now. We have to attend the maths class now, the science class. So psychological effect.
See, psychological effect means was, if we see in the morning, whenever students, they are coming to the school, they are very fresh. So they are eager to learn the various things. And so at that time, if we see the timetable, mostly the subjects they are having, the what you can say, the higher difficulty subject, they are always in there in the timetable initially. We can see the first, second lectures is all, or we can see the first lecture, first, second periods of science, maths and English, you can say. In between, there is a craft period. In between, there is a drawing period. In between, there is a technical, we can say the computer period. So the timetable should be managed in a such a way that the student, they will eagerly participate. They will get interest in the learning. So that is related to the psychological value. So here we are going to log the option number 3, that is both. Is it clear to you about the moral and psychological values? Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So the next, it is very simple. The skills required in event management is the communication skill, calm under pressure, listening, and all of the above. Which is the correct one? Yes. Good. Yes. Now find out odd man out. The options are painting, music, craft, and needlework.
Ma'am, music.
Needlework.
Okay, those who are saying that, of course, this is the correct option, that is the needlework. And now I'm expecting the justification why you have selected this particular option as correct option.
Ma'am, because all three are creative and one is productive.
Yes. Okay. Good. Yes. If we see the painting, music, and craft, they comes under the creative arts, and the needlework, it comes under the product art. Again, I'm going to share another slide, so we'll get idea about this. Yes. So these are the types of event, the curricular activities and the co-curricular activities. And among the co-curricular activities, again, there is a division, that is creative arts, product arts, literary arts, the cultural activities, sports and games, and excursions. Okay. So if we see here, the painting, the music, and craft, they comes under the creative arts. And here the needlework, it comes under the product arts. So automatically in the odd man out, we are going to select the option that is needlework. Is it clear to you? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Again, the question related to the co-curricular activities. Find out odd man out, and the options are poetry recitation, essay writing, debates, and knitting. Which is the correct one?
Knitting.
Knitting is odd.
Yes. Literary art and knitting, it comes under the product art. Okay. Yes. The next is, what is included in the post-event analysis? Feedback from participants, thanking all the volunteers, take a feedback regarding work done, and fourth is all of the above.
I logged all of the above.
All are agree with the option number 4. So should I log this option, all of the above?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. This is the correct option. What is full form of ICSE? The options are Indian Council for Secondary Education, International Council for Secondary Education, Indian Certificate of Secondary Education, and International Certificate for Secondary Education. Yes, option number. So all are agree with the C option. Yes, should I log this option?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, this is the correct option. Excellent answer. That is Indian Certificate of Secondary Education is the full form of ICSE. Yes. The next is ICS, and ICSE examination should be conducted in English language, and this recommendation is given by
AIEEE, ma'am.
Oh. Yes. The options are NP, that is National Policy on Education, 1986, 1968, 1992, and 2020.
I log first one, 1986.
Yes, 1980. See, this is the correct option. That is NP, 1986. And here, the one mistake was there. Can you tell me full form of ICS and ICSE? Actually, one mistake here, that is instead of writing ICS, I should write ISC. Now tell me full form of ISC and ICSE.
Indians.
Already we have saw the full form of this, that is Indian Certificate of Secondary Education. Yes, and what about the ISC? Indian School Certificate. Yes, and I'm going to share something for you. Yes, you can see here. See, basically, see, ICSE means it is related to 9th and 10th standard, and whenever we are talking about the ISC, that is Indian School Certificate, means here we are talking about the grades, or we can say the classes 11th and 12th. Yes. Now, which exam is not conducted by CBSE?
AIEEE, ma'am.
Yes?
AIEEE.
Yes, the correct option is AIEEE. Yes. Can you tell me the full form of AIEEE, and now who is conducting these particular examinations? Yes?
All India Entrance Engineering Exam.
All India Engineering Entrance Examination. Okay, you are very closer to answer. Good. Now, who is conducting this examination? Yes. Actually, if you see initially the CBSE board, they are only conducting this examination. But now this particular task is handed over to other agency. Can you tell me name of that agency?
NTA, ma'am. That is, I think, National Testing Agency.
Excellent answer. Yes, National Testing Agency, and formed from the year 2002. They are holding this examination. Very nice answer. I think Rohini was there, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Very nice, Rohini. Good. Yes, the next question is Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education is divided into dash dash educational divisions. And the correct option is?
Nine.
Yes, any other answer?
No, ma'am, nine.
Yes, correct option is nine. And again, I'm going to tell you that in some books it is given that eight, because later on the one more division that is added, that is nothing but the Konkan. Yes, and now the total number is nine. So correct option is three, that is nine. The next question is Maharashtra State Secondary Education Board renamed as Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education in the year dash dash. The options are 1976, 1966, 1972, 1962. Correct option is yes.
First one.
The correct option is first one, yes. Now tell me when this particular board established.
1966.
Yes, very nice. And the initial name was Maharashtra State Secondary Education Board, and it was established in 1966, and it is renamed as Maharashtra State Board of Secondary and Higher Secondary Education in 1976. Very nice. Yes, National Talent Search Research Exam is conducted by, the options are NCTE, NCERT, ICSE, and IGCSE. The NCERT. Correct option is yes, NCERT. Very. Very nice. That is NCERT is the correct option. Good. Yes. Now the next is yes. Meenal, can you read this and this question?
Which is not the type of administration?
Yes. And the options are autocratic, democratic, delegative, and instructional.
Ma'am, I think instructional would be the answer.
Yes, very correct answer. I'm going to log this answer, that is instructional. See, if we see the in the previous question, whatever options I have given, the options were leadership, democratic, delegative, and the participative. So if we see the democratic, and I'm going to switch over there. ऐसे आपको कंफ्यूज करने के लिए ऑप्शंस दे सकते हैं. आई जस्ट वांटेड टू टेल यू दैट. यस, हियर इन व्हिच टाइप ऑफ लीडरशिप, दैट वाज द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. एंड सी, द डेमोक्रेटिक एंड पार्टिसिपेटिव बोथ आर द सेम. दीज आर द सिनोनिम्स आई कैन से. सो अगर आपको ऐसे क्वेश्चंस दे, इंस्टेड ऑफ डेलीगेटिव ऑल्सो, इफ दैट वॉज नॉट द करेक्ट ऑप्शन, दे कैन टेल अस अबाउट द फ्री रेन, अ लेजी फेयर, दे कैन गिव द अदर ऑप्शंस ऑल्सो. सो यू शुड नो द डिफरेंट नेम्स फॉर द सेम. यस Yes, the next question is, which of the following is not an aspect of educational management? Now, the correct option, tell me the correct option. Management of financial resources, management of material resources, management of human resources, and management of student resource.
D.
Yes.
C1.
Yes. D. Any other?
Student resources.
Yes, because see, if we say the human resource, the automatically the student resource, it is a part of human resources. So we're going to select this option, which is not an aspect of educational management. Yes. The question number 25, that is, the word management is derived from the word
French. The
Latin, French, Japanese, and Sanskrit. Now tell me the word, French word, from which French word it is derived?
Manager.
Yes.
Management
and mismanagement, these are the two words from them. This particular management word is derived, and this is the French word. Yes, you should recall, remember the name, that is mismanagement and management. Yes,
yeah.
Educational management is, the options are not theoretical but use practical measures, dynamic in function, a system of authority, all of the above.
All of the above.
Yes, very nice. All I agree with the option number 4, so I'm going to log this option. The next is, this is, I'm expecting the quick and correct response from your side, because this is very simple and we are already dealing of this. Yes, yes. To manage is to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to control, to coordinate. This definition of management is given by the Henry Fiore. So option number 3 is correct. And if we see, you can see that different functions which are given by the Henry Fiore, which are highlighted here, that is forecasting, planning, organizing, commanding, controlling, and coordinating. Total 6 functions are there. So there may be chances of asking the questions that how many functions of management given by the Henry Fiore, and they will give options like 4, 5, 6, 7. You have to select the correct option, and correct option is yes.
6.
Yes, correct option is 6. Very nice. 28 number question, that is, teacher appraisal can be given in the form of praise, promotions, incentive, all of the above.
All of the above.
Yes, the correct option is all of the above. Educational management lays more stress on the democratic, decentralization, participation, and all of the above. I think this question is also new for you.
Yes.
Now tell me the correct option.
Should be all of the above.
Yes. The correct option is all of the above. See, initially there was a term, that is the educational administration, but nowadays the more focus is given on the educational management. And whenever we are talking about the educational management, is automatically it says about the democracy. There should be democratic way. There should be decentralization in decision making. And everyone who is a part of that particular organization or the institution should take, should participate in the different activities taken in the particular organization. So this educational management is lays more stress on all the three, that is democratic, decentralization, and the participation. So I'm going to log the option number 4, that is all of the above. Yes, again I'm expecting quick response from your side. An employee should receive instructions from his superior and should be accountable to only one superior. This Henry Fiore's principle is called as unity of direction, unity of command, order, and discipline. Yes, now tell me which is the correct option.
unity of command.
Yes, your voice is very low, so I think you are not sure with your answer. Yes.
Yes, we
should be confident about the answer. Yes, the correct option is unity of command, because order is nothing but the right person should be at the right place. Then the discipline teaches about the rules and regulations. So automatically, we are going to first eliminate these two, that is three, option number 3 and 4. And again, we are having confusion. See, whenever there is a unity of direction, means there should be particular planning, there should be particular action plan, and which gives direction to all the human resources who are the part of that particular organization. So they will get a direction how to go, how to work on the particular task. Yes. So here we are going to lock the option number 2, that is unity of command. Yes. Yes. The next is. Yes, Asta, can you please read this question? Okay, Deepika.
May I?
Yes, please.
Decisions are to be taken by the higher level manager, whereas decisions should be executed by lower level managers. This Henry Foyle's principle is called as?
Yes. And the options are, thank you, decision making, centralization in decision making, decentralization in decision making, and the fourth one is discipline. Now tell me which is the correct one. So here, please read the question carefully. The decisions are to be taken by the higher level managers, and the decisions are executed by the lower level managers. Yes. So this is related to?
Option 2, ma'am.
Yes, because the decisions are centralized decisions. The decisions are taken by the higher level managers and executed by the lower level managers. So here the option number 2 is correct. That is centralization in decision making. Good. Now find out the odd man out. The question is the 32 number question. The scalar chain, order, division of work, and ambiguity. Now tell me which is the... Yes, why? Why? Why you have selected this particular option?
Because these three are the Peter Drucker's scalar chain, order, division of work.
Yes, very nice. The initial three, that is scalar chain, order, and division of work, these are the principles of management given by the Henry Fayol. So automatically we are going to eliminate this option as a odd man out. So we are going to select the option number 4, that is ambiguity. Yes. The question number 33. Who will read this question? Yes.
Ma'am, I'll read.
Yes, please.
The UGC, however, was formally established in November as a statutory body of the Government of India through an Act of Parliament for the Coordination, Determination, and Maintenance of Standards of University Education in India.
And the options are 1956, 1946, 1966, and 1976. Now tell me which is the correct one. Yes, that is the correct. See, अगर ऐसे कोई भी क्वेश्चन आता है आपको ये जो भी ईयर्स है आपको रिमेम्बर करने के अलावा कोई चारा नहीं, लेकिन आप एक उनका ड्यूरेशन याद रख सकते हो. वहाँ पे उसका एक हायरार्की रहेगा कि कौन से ईयर में क्या हुआ था. उसका एक आप खुद के लिए नोट्स बना के रख सकते हो ताकि आपको अच्छे से याद रहे. ठीक है. यस. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन इज Ministry of Government of India responsible for implementation of the first option is one. Yes, because they are going to implement the national policy on education. So here I'm going to lock option number 1.
Ma'am, yes. One more question is regarding this, that Narendra Modi ji.
Yes, that is that next question.
2020,
yes, it,
no?
Yes, okay. Yes, yes, it is okay. There it is, I think the question number 36.
Okay.
Yes, India had the Ministry of Education since 1950, 1947, 1953. 47. Yes. क्या हुआ था 47 में? आप कहीं से तो उसका correlation भी लगा सकते हो ताकि आपको अच्छे से याद रहे.
Yes. Independent.
Yes. So आप वो याद रख के इसको ध्यान में रख सकते हो. Yes. The next question is, with the public announcement of newly drafted national policy, national education policy, or we can say national policy on education also, both are correct, dash dash, by the Narendra Modi government, Ministry of Human Resource Development was renamed back to the Ministry of Education in the year, yes, 2020, 1986. Yes, the option, correct option is 2020. Our great Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, he has renamed, or you can say, jo pehle naam tha, wahi unhone phir se rakha, and that name was Ministry of Education. At the state level, is the Minister of Education is appointed by the options are Chief Minister of the State, Prime Minister, yes, yes. The correct option is option number one, that is Chief Minister of the State. Yes, full form of AICTE is, and the options are All India
Tech Education.
Yes, yes. Aapne bahut very nice. All India Council for Technical Education. Now tell me, before moving ahead for the next question, solving next question, just tell me about the HRD Ministry. And HRD Ministry is divided into basic two divisions. And tell me the names of the divisions.
Sure.
And also tell me this particular council which we have selected at All India Council for Technical Education, it comes under which division?
Directorate of
Higher Secondary.
Okay, I'm moving to the next question, and you will find the answer of this question here. Through which departments our country is operating its educational administration? The first is Department of School Education and Literacy, Department of Higher Education, both of these and none of the above.
Both of these.
Yes. So this basically HRD Ministry is having two divisions. This is the first, Department of School Education and Literacy, and the second is Department of Higher Education. Okay. And if we see, there are three main, what you can say, the main agencies or the commissions, they are related to the Department of Higher Education and the commissions, where the first is the UGC, the second is the NCT, and the third is All India Council for Technical Education. You have to remember all these things. Yes. And so I'm going to log the option number three. That is the correct option, both of these. And now this is the last question. That is question number 40. Dash dash is a formal independent verification that a program or institution meets established quality standards and is competent to carry out specific conformity assessment tasks. And the options are evaluation, accreditation, management, and sort. So automatically, first, initially, we are going to eliminate these two. Yes, and we have to select from this. So which is the correct option? Accreditation is the correct option. Okay. So I think all questions are clear to you. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.